Hello everybody and welcome to a new episode of our tech podcast by Bosch Rexroth. My name is Robert Weber and today we are going to talk about charging mobile machines. And my guest today is Eric Engel. Welcome, Eric.
Hi, Robert.
Please introduce yourself briefly to the listeners.
My name is Eric Engel. I'm since April 2022 in Bosch Rexroth. Previous, I did my master thesis or my master's in mechanical engineering in RWTH Aachen.
With
the focus of automotive engineering. During my studies, I was able to get a look into the automotive sector and did there some internships and working as a working student. Mm-hmm. Afterwards, I did my master thesis for corporate research in for Bosch Central in Renningen. And there I get in touch with a guy from the E-Line project from Bosch Rexroth. And then he came to me and asked if I want to join as a software developer in Ulm for the E-Line project. And now I'm here. Yeah.
Why do we need to record an episode on charging? I think charging is simple.
Yeah, so charging is an everyday task from everyone. Everyone has at least one device, which is battery electrified. So the main difference for charging in the off-highway market is that it's a different voltage level. Mm-hmm. So basically we are in a range of 700 to 800 volts. And due to that, we have additional functions or safety related functions to that has to be taken into account for charging off-highway machines.
And we have different grids in different countries and different standards and
So basically in the European Union, we have the three-phase grid with 230 volts. And in North America, there is the 110 to 120 volt grid with one phase, pretty common. But in addition, we have several countries, for example, Brasilia, with hybrid net, I would call it. Okay. So you have several parts with the three-phase grid from the EU and also the one-phase grid from North America. So this is like pretty difficult for the OEMs, so for the our customers.
Can you explain us the Bosch Rexroth product? What is your charging product?
So our charging product is a mix between a hardware solution to enable the voltage, the charging of the battery, and also a software package where we enable different charging standards in the market.
Okay. So because I was wondering, because you are a software engineer, why do the team from E-Line needs a software engineer? Can you explain this a little more detailed?
Yeah. So we have different forms of charging. One is the AC charging. There we are limited to 22 kilowatts in power. In addition, we have the DC charging. Here we are not limited in the power, but we are have to communicate with an EVSE, so with a charging station.
Okay. So and your part is to enable the communication, a proper communication.
Yeah, this is the part of the software to enable the communication and also have some safety functions enabled that the vehicle, for example, is not overloaded. So basically that this is like the interface for the customer, the communication of the limits of the vehicle. So for example, how much current is allowed and how much voltage.
Why is this so difficult to develop, or why is it so important to develop a product for this approach?
Yeah, so the problem here is that in the off-highway market, we have different use cases. So if we are, for example, on the highway or on the road, then the loading is pretty similar to the automotive market. So for example, for tractors, it is really important. But if we are in different use cases, then the customer uses like own charging standard, I would call it. So he just connects.
Okay. Oh, that sounds very crazy.
Yeah. So he is connecting directly to the grid. Yeah. That's why we have like the challenge of the different grid forms.
Yeah.
And also, yeah, you have like higher power demands for DC charging in the off-highway market because, yeah, you need more energy compared to the automotive market.
What are the challenges with mobile machines concerning charging? Is it a topic of robustness, or what are the three main challenges?
So the main challenges in the off-highway market are firstly the robustness against mechanical loads.
Okay.
Then we have the use case that the vehicle...
So what is the solution? What is the solution to do that?
The solution is that if we choose components, you have to use components which are...
It's a sourcing topic then.
Yeah, okay. Yes, definitely. So basically, on the one hand, you have the components that has to be chosen wisely, and also the topic of the PCB layout.
Okay.
So we are doing like recursive testing, and for that... Yeah, we are taking account the additional loads from the off-highway market. And in addition, we have use cases for the off-highway market where the vehicle is connected to the grid for the whole time of usage. Mm-hmm. So basically, during operating, you have like long cables which are connected to vehicle to be the main power source. So this vehicle, for example, don't have a battery.
Ah, okay.
For the third, we have the parallel operation topic, because with one onboard charger, it's in several use cases not possible to deliver the required power. Mm-hmm. So that's why it is possible for our onboard charger to connect them in parallel.
Okay.
That you have like four times, for example, the power that one onboard charger can deliver. Yeah.
I want to go into detail to your product. Can you describe the listeners your product? Is it a hardware component packed with software? And where is it situated in this whole charging process?
Mm-hmm. So basically, we have two different hardware variants, one for the EU grid and the second one for the American grid. Mm-hmm. And on the software side, we have two different software packages. Mm-hmm. The first one, also the main software package, is the standalone variant. Mm-hmm. Here it is like a complete whole solution for the customer. Mm-hmm. So the communication and also all functionality is done by the onboard charger. So basically it is a pretty complex device inside the OBC.
The onboard charger is your product, right?
Yeah, this is our product.
The OBC,
The OBC, yes. Yep. So the onboard charger is a pretty complex component inside, but for the interface, for the customer, it is a pretty easy device to implement into the vehicle. Mm-hmm. So
the first one is a standalone solution?
Standalone solution, right. And the second one is a slave solution. Mm-hmm. For the slave solution, the loading communication is done by a different controller. So, for example, the vehicle control unit can do this task. And here the vehicle control unit is then doing the loading communication.
Okay.
And the OBC is just transferring the energy.
Okay. What is the demand of standalone solutions? Is the demand higher than a slave solution?
Yeah. So the charging topic is also for our customers a pretty new topic. Mm-hmm. Due to that, the standalone variant is more required or more demanded from the market.
When we talk about this standalone, the safety is a very important topic. What requirements on safety do you have with your OBC?
So for the OBC, we took the on the market demanded safety standards into account during development phase. So for example, the ISO 13849. So this is like functional safety on onboard charger side here.
And how do you integrate this OBC into the customer's system? Can you go, because we are focused on the standalone solution, can you go a little bit more in details?
So for OBC, we have like three main interfaces. So on the one hand, we have the HV interface. Here, the OBC is connected to the battery, so to the intermediate circuit. Mm-hmm. The second interface is the AC connection. It is the connection to the inlet, so to the interface to the loading station. And the third interface is the low voltage interface. Mm-hmm. Here is the communication and also the power supply of the PCB enabled, yeah.
And how difficult is it for customers, for your customers to manage this? So they choose to stand alone because you manage everything for them, or why they choose this solution?
So this is like the main aspect here. The problem is that the market is really dynamic. Mm-hmm. So we have, for example, like the NACS standard.
Yeah, it's a Tesla standard.
Tesla standard, right? So this is like a whole new topic in the United States and was a pretty fast decision. And for example,
there was no decision. Everybody said, okay, we will do it.
Yeah, we also like that. It was like that, yes. Yeah. Yeah, correct. Yeah. And for several countries, we don't have a charging standard which is communicated. So here, for example, like Africa or Asia, maybe it will be CCS or NACS.
And everything depends on these inlets, right? Is that right?
So yeah, the communication is somehow connected to the inlets.
Yeah.
So we are also able to support different inlets in the OBC. So this is done by parameterization. Mm-hmm. So you have like three aspects for every inlet, which is different. You have the connection to the LEDs, the actuation of the locking, and also the temperature sensors has to be somehow different supported for every inlet.
What does NACS now mean for your software and for your hardware?
So the NACS is basically a different charging communication standard. So here the OBC has to do the right handshakes to enable this. So you have to adapt the software. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, it is, for example, for the NACS, there is also then the Tesla inlet supported. And for that, yeah, like I said, you have to take the three problems. So for example, the LEDs, the actuator and the temperature sensor has to be enabled in the OBC.
So it's a new job for you, a new task.
It's a new task, yes.
It's a new software task, right?
Yeah.
So it's a very complex market you mentioned.
Yep.
Why did you choose to go in this market as a Bosch Rexroth? Because it's very complicated. If somebody changes something, you have to change the software. What is so special and so interesting at the market?
Yeah, so basically we are working on that because for a battery electrified vehicle, it is an important component, and we are, as the Eliant team, are selling also system architecture or system solutions. That's why it's an important part of it, with our experience in the off-highway market and also with the Bosch knowledge, we are able to offer a solution for this problem.
What's next? What's coming next? And what's your next task? What are your next jobs to do, Eric?
So currently our main focus is on the start of production, on the official start of production of the OBC and DC-DC. This contains much work in documentation, for example. Also, one major task currently is to check the market.
If there's a new Tesla.
Yeah, for example, if there is a new Tesla standard or something like that, to offer here also solutions to the customer to be state of the art with the onboard charger. And also we are working to enable further inlets. So basically to enlarge our portfolio of the inlets. This is also a main task, yeah.
We wish you all the best. Thank you, Eric. It was a pleasure.
Thank you, Robert, yeah.